Coverage of the NFL brings us to Oakland, California. On first down, gone. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers putting up their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
So when you saw him dump it off to the back, did you think he was going to pick up the first down there?
Well, I knew one thing. It wasn't his primary target. At least it didn't look like it. Turned out to be the play they needed, though. And it's big because it's the opening drive. So converting that third down, keeping the play, not the play, the drive going.
Yeah, it certainly appeared like his downfield targets were covered. Threw the little dump off to his back, and nice effort picking up the first down, though. And you're right. That opening drop
into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. If you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have back on their heels.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A Raiders first down, Carr hooking up with Cook.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
On second down, Lynch. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. It's a loss of 4. Now third down. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
And third down is a key down.
Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
How about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one. And that was a good run. This was only one of 9 guys to go over 1,000 yards in 2017. And I think you can't let him run wild here.
What do you think, 100 yards, the measuring stick?
Always. That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. From the gun on third down, gone. He may try and run for this. A good decision in the end to pull it and run, get some 9 yards and a first.
I'm not sure he falls under the category of mobile quarterback, but he's athletic enough that if you don't keep your rush lanes intact, he finds a way to hurt you.
As coaches like to say, I wouldn't call him a burner, but enough there in the tank.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
It's a gain of five, and that'll bring up second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break the tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charlie. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On first down, it's Gurley. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, that one was over before it could get rolling. How about the D just knifing into the backfield and shutting that one down?
The throw on second down is gone. And that's complete to Cooks. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football. But you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Now gone. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Goff to Woods as the Rams move the chains.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three.
And there's the first tackle of the game for Carl Joseph. He's one of those safeties that you can utilize in any way you want. But I will have to say, I think the number one thing he does best is tackle.
And yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Here's Goff now on second down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Woods. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and eight. Remain in a scoreless first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. And time to remind you that coming up at halftime, we're off to see the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando. He'll have a look back at a wild opening weekend in the NFL. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Tyler Higbee taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Rams are in for six.
When you give up a long touchdown drive, you're looking for a silver lining. In this case, it's the fact that your offense had a chance to rest, and now they...
his way up to about the 44 here. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. The Raiders try to move quickly, try to get everybody back to the line. To throw his car. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that's going to lead to a third and 11. Carr to throw after the play fake to Lynch. He's going to float this one deep right side. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four. And the Rams getting set to go now.
Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive, that culminating touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now.
And now.